Hello and welcome to another instalment of Tech of the Week, Trusted Reviews weekly tech talk, weekly show where we talk about tech of the week. I'm Tom Newton, the computing editor for Trusted Reviews, and I have with me Ryan Jones, computing writer.
Yep.
And we've got a couple of portable computers with us to show you. So what have you got for us, Ryan?
So I've got the Razer Blade Stealth.
Razer Blade Stealth?
Yes,
okay.
That's it. It's basically just a really compact, cool little laptop. And obviously Razer are known for their gaming kind of lineup.
Yep.
And while this can do a bit of gaming, like Fortnite, Overwatch, it's not the beefiest of computers.
Okay.
This is compact first. This is right. All about portability. Think more along the lines of a MacBook Air or a LG Gram Rival.
Okay, it very much looks like it's a kind of slimmed down version of the Razer Blade 15, is that right?
Yeah, that's basically what it is, but like, with not having like a really beefy graphics card, this has got the NVIDIA GeForce MX150 graphics card.
MX150.
Okay. So like I said, you're not going to be able to run the likes of Shadow of a Tomb Raider or Battlefield 5 on this thing.
Right, this but for light gaming, for casual gaming, Fortnite, that kind of stuff, this is ideal, you'd say?
Yeah, that's okay. Really ideal. For me, I think it's a great kind of versatile laptop you bring in the office. You do some work, and then on your lunch break, you play Call of Duty, but Fortnite.
Yeah, okay.
Or some kind of indie game.
Overwatch.
Okay. I played Overwatch on it before, and right. It's got pretty good stable frame rates, good performance.
So I was just about to ask you, Ryan, what the resolution of this is, and I can see from the letters, the big capitals, which just show the camera, it says up here it's full HD.
Full HD, pretty obvious,
so yeah. So I answered my own question there. But how big is that? Is that 13 inches?
13.3 inches,
13.3.
To be precise, yes.
Okay. Well, we like to be precise.
Of course. So, yeah, full HD, pretty, I think you don't really want too much more. This isn't really that powerful enough to render 4K games anyway.
So then
full
HD is
great.
Sure, okay.
But saying that, if you do want the 4K option to like have your Netflix feasts or whatever, there is a 4K option for about £300 more.
Okay.
And it's touchscreen as well, so if you fancy that kind of thing.
So there's a 4K option for this for an extra £300.
Yep.
What's the basic price for this?
Oh, well, the price for this is about £1,500.
Okay.
So
you're still looking at just shy of £2,000 for a 4K gaming laptop?
Yes, just shy of £2,000.
That's
reasonably priced, I suppose, because usually they're over £2,000. But this is £1,500 for like I said, mainly it's for its compact form. It can play your basic games. I think it's a pretty good deal. Like, I would... To be honest, I'm hoping Razer don't call it back too soon, because I'm a pretty big fan of it, and this is the kind of laptop I'd love to bring to work. And
it does look really nice.
Like a backlit keyboard as well, which they can like customize to change color or fix color.
So you don't get the full complement of the standard RGB lighting stuff that you would normally get with a gaming laptop, but these the underlighting of the keys here, they can be made to shine whatever color you like, right?
Yep, and they can like sync up with your, like if you've got any Razer accessories like a mouse or a keyboard,
yep.
Then they'll sync up, glow the same color, and it's like really satisfying.
Nice, okay. If you're into that sort of thing. So this is like the sort of junior partner of the kind of Razer gaming laptop family. So it is the kind of...
The runt of the family.
The mini Razer Blade 15, essentially.
But at the same time, not really a gaming laptop, more a lifestyle kind of ultrabook.
Okay.
Has a dose of gaming capabilities. Think of a MacBook Air,
but
more gamer.
Lifestyle ultrabook. So speaking of lifestyle products, and I really do hate lifestyle as a term, you know, for consumer electronics devices, I do have with me here the ASUS Zenbook 15. And as you can see, it's not your typical sort of boring grey, black and silver laptop.
It's quite swanky, actually.
Yeah.
I'm liking the blue.
It's got this very nice blue and gold trim, which is, as I said, it's a little different than usual. It's got the classic ASUS spun metal finish here, which is this kind of lenticular, concentric sort of effect, which kind of like makes it stand out from the pack a little bit.
Yeah,
but
definitely.
I think for me, as well as looking a little bit nicer, one of the key takeaway points about this device is that it has a Whiskey Lake CPU in it, and that's the codename for Intel's latest version of the 8th gen of laptop CPUs. It's not going to be quite as powerful as an Ice Lake machine, and we're going to maybe see some Ice Lake machines later in the year, but this is still pretty good. This was announced IFA 2018, and one of the really cool things about Whiskey Lake systems is that they can handle really fast Wi-Fi, so-called gigabit Wi-Fi. And I know gigabit Wi-Fi is one of those terms that's been thrown around for a few years, which suggests that you might be able to get gigabit wireless transfer speeds. And Well, we've not really been able to do a lot of throughput testing here at Trusted Reviews. I did see a demo of gigabit Wi-Fi in action at EFA last year. And yeah, it's maybe not a gigabit a second, but it's pretty fast. I saw a 10 gigabyte file transferred in under 5 seconds over Wi-Fi to a device similar to this one. Not this exact device, but it's pretty good nonetheless. So I think if you're going to be, the takeaway point is, if you're going to be streaming like high definition video from Netflix, or if you're going to be playing games and you're not wired in, it's not necessarily going to be a problem.
You don't have to suffer the buffer circle.
You don't have to suffer the buffer, absolutely. So there's no Ethernet ports on this, but one thing I do like about ASUS is they are generally kind of generous by, you know, you tend to get an adapter thrown in the box. And one of the USB-A ports, I believe it's this one here on the right-hand side, that supports transfer speeds up to 10 gigabits a second. Okay. So, you know, whether you go wired or wireless, you know, your connection speeds on this device are going to be pretty good, I think.
So last year Zenbook had like a really weird kind of touch display kind
that's
of
right,
thing.
Yeah.
Does this one have it?
No, this doesn't have the ASUS screen pad, which we did feature that in a previous Tech of the Week. That's where the trackpad was also a secondary display, which is kind of cool, but
like a mini or huge DS almost.
Yeah, like a kind of dimorphic Nintendo DS with a really tiny secondary screen. It was kind of a cool concept, but I think it needed work. This does not have a screen pad in it. As I said earlier, this is a cheaper version of the Zenbook Pro. I still think it's pretty decent. If you're not in the market for something with a like a super color accurate screen and an i9 CPU, I don't think you would go far wrong by picking up one of these. Price-wise, it's about, it ranges between about 1,600 to 1,800, depending.
Okay.
Obviously, the Core i5 version is gonna be a little bit cheaper, and you know, you get the faster processor, you know, obviously things are going to be a bit more expensive.
One thing that most impressed me about this laptop is the graphics card.
Right, okay.
Remind me which exactly
So this model's got an NVIDIA 1050.
There we go.
And it conforms to the Max-Q sort of design standards. It's a very thin laptop, 17.9 millimeters thin, if I recall correctly. So, and this has the MX-120, right?
150,
sorry.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, like I said, this even though this is kind of has a gaming heritage of its brand, this will probably run games better. It's not a gaming laptop again, of course,
right.
But it's probably going to get better frame rates, right?
And yeah, I mean, we haven't done a head-to-head test with these yet, and I've yet to run any gaming benchmarks on this, but that would be my hunch too. And that said, we are going to be seeing gaming laptops hitting the shelves this year with NVIDIA's 20 series GPUs built into them. So I suppose if gaming is your primary concern, this might not be the one you want to reach for right now. You might want to wait and see. However, I think if you want a stylish looking laptop to do a little bit of light gaming in between office work, kind of like you were saying with this, really.
Yeah.
I think this will more than handle the basics, I think. But as I said, we've yet to do any head-to-head testing between these two. But maybe that'll be something we could do for a future show.
Sure. Maybe we could get like an Overwatch tournament going on in the office on a lunch break.
I mean, I wouldn't like to do that because I would lose. there's no argument there.
No argument with you, don't worry.
Okay, so, right, in terms of, so again, can we just quickly recap on the price of this one?
So this is about 1,500 for this model.
For that particular model.
With the HD MX-150 graphics card. Yeah.
Right, and you can get up to 4K resolution.
There's more expensive model, that's the about £300.
Right, so this will only, you've only really got full HD options with this one, so.
Yeah.
It has a bigger screen as well, so I guess on even the full HD version on the pure pixels per inch count, that's gonna maybe look a little bit better as well.
Yeah, but again, is there really much need to spend so much money on a 4K laptop unless you're really into your Netflix?
That's a good point.
Well, some people obviously will like it, and fair enough, but for the general consumer, I'm not so sure.
Okay. Right, we've talked about resolution, we've talked about price. I think we should draw attention to the fact that while these are very fetching looking devices,
like they're really fetching.
They're a little bit fingerprinty as well.
That's true. Like, we actually cleaned these laptops up before we came to the video studio, didn't we?
So before the camera started rolling, we did give these a little spruce, but
you can already see like how grimy it looks.
So
and I don't even remember touching it all those places.
I don't think you did.
I think it just appeared out of nowhere.
So I think maybe the fingerprint test should be part of the trusted criteria going forward. What do you reckon?
I think so, but if that was the case, I think these would both fail quite well. That doesn't look too bad, I suppose, is it?
I don't know about fail, but there definitely have to be a sliding scale for What was the term that Apple introduced with, I think it was the iPhone 4, oleophobic, oil repelling.
is definitely not that.
So that's not as oleophobic as this. No. This is the bigger oleophobe of the two.
Yes.
I think, definitely.
But that said, I think it's still a pretty sexy laptop, if you can say that.
Yeah, I think they're both sexy.
Yeah, like a black matte chassis and... quite sus, because usually you've got like the green logo here, but this is quite like an understated right. kind of one.
It is a bit more understated. You don't have that pulsing neon light firing out of the back.
The main reason for that is so you can game on your lunch break and not have your boss going, is that a gaming laptop?
Yeah, but I don't know. I'm seeing more and more gaming laptops are going with this slightly more conservative design route. They're going for something that, like you said, you could maybe sneak into the office and it wouldn't turn any heads. If you do kind of work in a place where it's BYOD. I generally think that most people wouldn't really care what machine you're using, but like, maybe, you know.
Some people don't want their laptop looking like a Tokyo high street then, I suppose.
That's true, so. Yeah. I mean, I think they all look ridiculous, as you know. So I'm personally happy with this a little bit more, dare we say, grown-up style of gaming laptop. So,
but don't take the backlit keyboard away from me. I love the purples
well,
and greens.
I'm not going to do that.
But, thank you.
That's all we have time for on this week's Tech of the Week. If you're watching this as the video goes up on our YouTube channel on Sunday, the review of this device will be live, so we will throw a link in the description.
And a review of this will be next week, hopefully, at some time.
So, if you're watching this, I don't know how that works out if you're not watching it on Sunday.
So this week?
This week, or is it next week? I don't know. Thanks again for watching Tech of the Week. We'll be back next week. If you have any comments or questions, you know what to do, leave them in the same place. And we will see you again soon. Thank you very much for watching.
Thanks, bye.
I'm gonna stop that again because I spat on the laptop. I'm just doing this to annoy you. I'm not really, I promise. I
mean,
like,
Damons.
Demon.
Matt Damon.
Can we start that again? That wasn't. I was going good, and then I fucked it up. Okay, all right.
Start singing Bar Bar Black Sheep.
Anyway, are you ready? No, he's not. Fucking hell.
No, I'm ready.
Okay, all right.